Where's my battery?
So bright back there.
Do you feel awkward?
No.
Oh, you're
just never know where to look. I want to look at you.
You can look at me.
Okay.
But we're going to tell a story. Look at the fuzzy ball.
There we're telling the story to the fuzzy ball.
There you go. I wonder if we're going to get stopped at every... So we're set up here in a parking lot by Walter Bridge.
This is actually the Alberta legislator. So that's probably why.
So in saying that, the sheriff police circle this area just to make sure there's no hooligans. They already asked us once what we were doing.
And they're like parked.
Now they're parked right
20
there.
Feet behind us.
They can just join us. We'll say welcome to the episode. Yep. YouTube video. You said podcast. Okay, welcome back to another video. I was gonna say episode. I guess it could be an episode. I wanted to make a full detailed nitty-gritty video about how we found the van. The process of finding the van was rather difficult. There were a lot of tears, but that's not surprising because I cry at everything. How I found the van and what that process looked like, because friends really all know is that I wanted to do van life and I have a van, but no one knows where it came from or how I got it. Steve, my lovely boyfriend, is here to tell the story also, because he is the reason this van is in existence in my life, and he knows what I went through, and we went through it together.
Yep.
So he is here today to tell the story as well. It was August last year, reconnected, and I was saying how I wanted to do van life and like that's what I was gonna do. 2, maybe 3 months, I would look on Kijiji and Facebook Marketplace going towards the idea of buying an already converted van, because that was one cost I had to do, knowing that I couldn't afford a van and a conversion. And I didn't have anyone to convert my van either, so it was just easier to buy something that was already converted. Also, if that is an option that you're doing, Kijiji and Facebook Marketplace both do have great vans out there. I didn't feel comfortable buying a van that had already been traveled in. I could look at the under the hood in the front and I would not even know what I'm looking at. I had a vision, you know? And then Steve came in the picture.
Took me a while to get an idea of what you were, because I remember looking on Kijiji and Facebook Marketplace, sending you options that were sending you were so far off.
So far off.
Like it almost.
Do you know what he sent me?
Or which one? There's two.
Okay, the
there's
Sprinter. Two. Okay, I said Mercedes Sprinters. There's a spider coming down off my camera. Look at him. You see that? I said I didn't even want to go towards Sprinters because they're more expensive than a Ford or a ProMaster. Maintenance done on the vehicle, which obviously I'm sure I will. You have to go to a Mercedes dealership. And if I'm in the boonies, I'm not going to find a Mercedes dealership. So don't even send me one. And then he sent me one.
Okay, so one, it was in Edmonton. It was within your price.
It was beautiful.
Fully converted. It just didn't have the layout that you were looking for.
Yeah, it was honestly really nice.
And it was about where we're at right now in terms of budget. It was about $15,000 less expensive.
Yeah.
And it was ready immediately.
Just like, I don't know, I wasn't comfortable buying something from somebody else.
To buy something converted based on the convenience. But then once we started down the conversation or the line of conversation of this is possible, we can find the proper people to help convert this.
After he sent me the Sprinter, he sent me a...
No. The first set of vans that I ever sent you before we actually started looking at stuff, a FedEx truck, like a yellow FedEx truck, like the big square box.
Yeah, ones. And he's worried about my safety and he sends me a FedEx truck that doesn't even have a door on the side.
Her budget was 15 to 20,000, and then we ended up tripling that budget.
A strict monthly
financial plan provided by yours truly.
Yeah, it's like my boyfriend, accountant, business partner. Is that it?
Yeah, I need more jobs on this resume.
Wait, it's partner.
Chef. Doctor.
No. So yes, he sent me a delivery truck. So I was like, no go. We were going on a little road trip to Jasper, and that's where the conversation started. Why don't you look for just a van? Because a van potentially could be cheaper and easier to find someone to convert it. And the only reason why I didn't was because I had nobody to convert it. So we're driving down the road and then Steve calls someone, no idea who he's calling, and he starts this conversation and then he just asks, and the other guy on the phone was like, yeah,
I could do that.
And I was like,
okay. So Alan and I have been friends for a decade. Father's and his brother's in carpentry. He started basically a carpentry and general contracting business.
Now we have someone that can convert a van, so then the search went to just finding a van.
Can you find a van? The universe.
Oh, and at this point, I was looking for a ProMaster.
Nope.
Yeah.
Why did we go down the ProMaster?
Because that's what I wanted before, remember? Because your neighbor had a ProMaster, we went into it, and I was like, we even sketched my first sketches for a ProMaster, and then...
But we got the timeline backwards. Oh, I don't remember now.
Okay, doesn't matter. We don't need to do that. Yeah. We was looking at ProMaster Rams first. We went to the dealerships. Okay.
We added all of this because our timeline's messed.
Yeah, our timeline's messed. But the point is that I wanted a ProMaster first.
Yeah.
And then we also looked at Fords.
We're looking for a ProMaster. We're looking for a Ford Transit. Do I have any connections? I'd say within 20 minutes, I got a few DMs.
After he put up a Facebook post.
But then one came in, a guy named Mike, works in the window and door industry with myself, but he used to work in commercial vehicle sales.
Yeah.
So he had a connection who still works in commercial vehicle sales. So it was a favor that to companies.
Are you allowed to say that?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to get somebody in trouble. It was a personal favor for somebody who did a one-off deal. Happened to fall into our laps.
Right.
Mike knew me, and he introduced us to Kevin.
Yeah, okay. Okay, yeah. Kevin?
To Kevin.
And Kevin owed Mike a favor, and everybody just owed everybody favors, and I was just like, hi! We gave him the specs of the height, length I wanted, my budget. Went ahead and did all the searches and stuff.
Controls vans from Vancouver Island all the way out to Newfoundland.
Ooh, backtrack for a sec.
Yeah, of course.
We were looking at the ProMasters. You called your buddy, and your buddy said that Amazon had bought all the...
Oh, yeah, like, because of COVID, and everybody ordering through Amazon and FedEx, buying all the vans that are coming off the assembly line for the next 2 years. It was
2 years?
Up to 2 years.
It was a long time. Because when that happened, we were like...
They're like, good luck, you're going to find one at a scrapyard.
Yeah, like, what are we going to do? The universe just, like, brought Kevin and Mike. That's, like, really... how it happened.
Without Kevin and Mike,
I would have not gotten the perfect van. After we realized, like, crap, this is actually gonna be harder than we thought, because nowhere in Alberta basically can I buy or find a van that I wanted.
Can we say the mileage?
Is what I wanted. Yeah, we'll get there. He did call and was like, you're asking me to find you a unicorn, because they were even very hard to find for him. Kept calling with updates. I think I found one. It's in Vancouver within my budget.
You wanted under 50,000 kilometers.
Oh my God, that's right. Wanted under 50,000 for my kilometers. Anything 100 and up, I was like, nope. Yep. And then he found a mid-roof 250 Ford Transit. It's a 2020. And I was like, okay, it's getting better. And then he was like, it has 9,000 kilometers on it. And I was like,
slightly more than like.
It was how many more of the budget?
I'd say about 10% more than we were budgeting.
Again, safety is obviously more, and trust the universe, it'll work out. We found a van. When I was first looking for vans and I was told to look province-wide, I was like, I don't want to do that, and how am I going to get it? I don't know, the universe just took care of me. We had two options. We could either fly and drive and go get it, which wasn't really an option for either of us because we had to work. They said the cost of a windshield for those vehicles, correct me if I'm wrong, but he said $1,200.
That's exactly the number.
The chances of it being chipped was high, so I was like, and it was winter. Yeah, that's the thing 12. Too. It was going to cost the amount the same. Shipping was $1,100, but it was going to be that much, if not more, actually, to drive it, and like more inconvenient to drive it.
Found the van, found a way to get it here. Now it's just financing the van.
I'm with TD, so I went to TD Bank. I went to a bank that I don't ever go to in an area that I'm never in. Actually, the only reason why I went to that bank was because we needed to get in the next day after finding this van at 9 a.m. And that was the quickest appointment we could get, was at this location. So, but I'm like, never been here before, but you know what? We're gonna go with it.
Enter.
Chaos.
That's a good
night
one.
Frustration.
What was her name again?
Stella.
Meeting
we
with
love
Stella.
No, she wasn't flustered.
Remember, she was like,
just
throwing the papers.
I honestly think it was just her personality. We were like all chatting, raised her hand at one point, and was like, I have a question.
Yeah, like she was like, a student, and we're like, you're in charge here. Like,
I actually think she's just never had done like an automotive
loan.
Yeah, whatever. We gave her the practice, but let me freaking tell you guys. She asked me information I didn't have, and I was trying to get it, and like everyone was talking, papers were everywhere, things were flying. Like it was just like chaos. Like, what do I even say? This experience with the bank,
like,
it was tough because I'm not using it for commercial use. I do not have a business.
But end to end, I think the process took 2.5 to 3 weeks.
No.
To get the van approved.
It took like 2 months. It took a month.
Month.
It took a long time.
Yeah.
I was already pre-approved for a loan, but we were asking for more than what I was like automatically pre-approved for. It got rejected. I didn't make enough or something.
Yeah.
Which, whatever. That's honestly normal. So I need a co-signer. That's easy. Loving father. But because he owns a business, they deemed it that my vehicle was going to be used for his business. My dad had a 42-page document that he had to send her one by one to prove it wasn't being used for a commercial vehicle.
So Stella had a day off. Your dad submitted the paperwork.
She didn't tell us she was going on vacation, and the dealership in Vancouver was like waiting for us. We were inches away probably from losing the vehicle.
And the market was so hot that they could have sold it that same day.
Yeah. Kevin and Mike, I don't know, owed each other and had a bro connection. they worked together. Everybody. And I was the only one that they were actually waiting a month or more for. Again, many tears. I cannot lose this vehicle, and I'm not gonna lose it on Stella's day off. So long story short,
there was tears.
It was a horrible experience, because when you literally have a dream and it's like inches away, you found it and then it's inches away from being taken from you.
We were within a couple days of losing it for sure.
Yeah, it was very devastating. Everything gets approved. The payment is here. I have the bank draft in my hand. Now I have to mail it.
I forgot about this
part. I have to mail it to BC, which means it's gonna take a couple days to get there. I mailed the bank draft. My job
is done.
I mailed the bank draft. And then the next day I was like,
I only mailed half.
I forgot to give my deposit. Like,
financed a certain amount of the loan, but the remainder you were paying in cash.
The next day I realized that I forgot to like pay the rest of the through my own money. So then I had to go back to the bank, get another check of my own money, go back to the post office, send it away.
So this poor guy in BC, we finally tell him we have the money and the money's in the mail, and he's sitting there waiting, saying there's no money coming.
The delivery company is like, I'm ready, I can pick it up today. And I was like, sweet, I'm like praying, just please pick it up today, and like trust the check's gonna get there. But they wouldn't release the vehicle to him because they didn't have the second check. It was probably a week maybe before the delivery company could go pick up the van.
They said it was gonna be about 5 to 7 days.
Let me think about this. They said that the van was gonna leave on Saturday, get there Thursday. It was like a Monday or Tuesday.
We got a call at 7 o'clock at night
saying that it was gonna be there.
It was gonna be there at midnight.
1 a.m. or whatever. Yeah. And I told the delivery company, I'm like, this is my whole world. This is my baby. This is my dream. This is my everything. Please keep it safe. Keep it safe. Priority number one is this van. You know how they have these, like those transport trucks with the cars stacked? My van was at the very top, as close to the...
like over top of the cab.
Like over top of the, yeah, truck cab. March?
Yeah, it was like slushy. Like everything else was dirty.
It was dirty. Every other car on that freaking truck was like brown and black. He had to like clean the windows before he drove it off the truck.
Because they were so dirty.
Yeah, because he couldn't see. But then my van was like as white and pearly as it could be. It was so spotless. There wasn't a speck on it. It was so perfect. They listened to me. You can't actually, I don't know, like you can't explain what it was like unless you like live it.
I want to say that was 6 weeks. Having that.
Actually, we didn't even talk about that. This is why this van is here. So like we have to explain that for a second. Okay, so also why I wasn't gonna buy a van to convert it was because I didn't have the money to like buy a van and then spend the money to convert it. Went to Remedy Cafe.
So this should be my portion.
Okay, go.
And I said, you have this dream and you're very serious about this dream. From a relationship standpoint, we couldn't really, at that point, we couldn't really start our relationship until you had lived van life, because that was that mode you were in. It was van came first, travel, and then
priorities.
Potentially start a relationship afterwards. So I'm like, hey, we gotta get this going then.
That's why he was sending me delivery trucks, because he was like, I gotta get this girl a van so she can go do her things so that we can be in a relationship.
That was my driving motivation. slightly selfish. But I said, let's sit down and let's see if this is
memory card full. Okay, we're back. What were we?
In November, when we sat down at Remedy, we wanted to make sure that the dream made sense on paper, financially speaking.
It's gonna cost. You're shortening it. What were you saying before?
Hardest part is actually getting you to spend money. I didn't realize that at that point.
Yeah, that was a very short version, which is great. We looked at how much I made per month. Wait, what did we do? We looked at how much I made per month. Yeah, and like
and
how
much. And I
said,
if you save this amount of money every month,
it'll take this long to
buy. April, you can afford this much money. May, June, July. And I just said, look, it depends on how much the van's going to cost.
Yeah.
But you could have this much money by then.
Yeah. When he, like, put it together, I actually saw that, like, I could do this. I cried.
Yep.
Night, I was freaking out. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is actually real life. I could actually do this.
You were talking about it. A lot of, like, this is what I'm doing. There's nothing that's going to stop me. But you didn't have a plan at that point.
I was just going to save as much money as I possibly could and trust the universe that the universe was going to plop a van in front of me. And I was just going to know that that was the one.
technically it did. Technically I was the universe. I was the gift from the universe. That sounds very egotistical, but.
But I thought like I was gonna save enough money and like a converted van was just gonna pop in front of me.
Yeah.
Like the idea of building it wasn't really a thing. After that date in Remedy, it was literally life changing. I cried because I was like, dang, this is real. And everything just like fell into place. The four mason jars, and I had X dollars in each one, and like my food, my entertainment, clothing. My clothing.
It's always the other one.
We always miss that. Mm-hmm. Food, entertainment, clothing.
Miscellaneous.
No.
There's a miscellaneous one.
Entertainment, food, clothing, household items.
Yeah.
And I can only live off of this each month.
You just lived by that theory, and I said if you just live by that, live by your jars.
Yeah.
Then by April, May, June, July of
2021. And I lived that way from January. And then the rest of my savings was going towards
the conversion. July.
That's a whole other video.
Okay.
Well, I guess the problem was that
we didn't have somebody to do the electrical. That's the problem.
My builder is good with woodworking and like the lighting stuff, because
basic house. The actual hardwire.
But the hardwire and the pre-wire for like connecting it to the van battery and the solar panels.
A lot of electricians know how to wire a house, but a van is a lot different from a house.
Yeah.
And the heater is connected to the gas tank and it draws gas from the gas tank. So like
I didn't want to blow up.
You don't want to blow up.
Previously, before all this happened, I had joined on Facebook a bunch of like van life Facebook pages, and I saw this wonderful lady from Sir Edmonton. Anyways, she had like just bought a ProMaster, and I was so jealous. I'm like, bitch, where did you find this? Like, I cannot find one. And she had a company in Canmore doing her conversion.
Dan the man
and Brittany. They were lovely. Kathy is her name here in Edmonton. I found Dan the man and Brittany, and I reached out to them and said, I don't need you to do everything. I just really need the electrical and potentially like my water system.
They were more than happy to help.
They were so great. They were so great. We just said like, we will drive there as much as possible to have you guys do this portion because it's so incredibly important. We drove to Canmore twice.
They're back. Probably like 4 to 5 times.
We drove to Canmore
to drop it off.
We did two trips, right. Okay. Yeah. We did two trips, but we had to drive 4 times, right?
Gotcha.
That's right. And then one day he had to work till 3. So we left the city at like 4 or 5
p.m.
Went to Canmore and got home at like 1 or 2 in the morning.
2 in the morning.
I will do anything. And we did. And it was exhausting, but so worth it.
So advice to anyone who's building a van is find a woodworker and find an electrician.
Or like if a company does van conversions as their career, which nowadays is happening. When I was first looking for a van, I did read, look everywhere, look at a province, look out of the country. And I was like, no, I don't want to do that. But now that I've done that, it's really not that hard. It's a lot of like resourcing, like who's the shipper, you know, and just making sure you get all your documents. Like, it's definitely possible. Yeah, I think that's it. I think that's the whole short version of how I found my van. Showing me on paper that little old me can afford a Ford Transit cargo van. I would have probably done it a lot differently and would not be as far as I am. So I'm grateful. Thank you.
Not to be too sentimental, but I think we make a great team because you dream big and I find a way to put those dreams.
Use my fire.
There you go.
My Aries makes shit happen because I don't always do that good. Yeah, I think that's it. Is that all? We didn't miss anything? I do have another video of the whole build process and for the most part what that looks like. At this stage recording now, it's June 28th. We're like halfway done.
Spoiler alert, we ran into a couple hiccups, but yeah. I've always said to you, there is no obstacle that we can't find a way to overcome. Yeah. Finding a way around the obstacle.
There was a delay with the builder, which is honestly kind of beyond his control too. So yeah.
When you do something this big, you just have to expect that some things are going to try and get in your way. But if your dream is big enough and your determination is there, there's always a way around.
I think the toughest part is my perfectionist inside of me. I tried to learn electrical once. It's so intense. I don't know.
It's trusting that the people that you've chosen to work on the van are going to do a great job with the things you don't know how to do.
And like being okay with not being in control, which for me is sometimes very difficult. I think it depends on the person, and I think it depends on like just each van build for people who do it are going to be different.
Edmonton.
This happened to me yesterday. I have had multiple tears and lots of frustration, but I was also told. It's not like I expected it and I was like, make it happen. I was told it was gonna be also done. Might be a little bit delayed and that's okay. But my point is that I have a builder doing my van. So excited that I just really want to enjoy this now. Whereas there's people my age, if not younger than me, building the van by themselves. When I look at mine, I'm like, ah, so frustrated. But then I look at other people and I'm like, it could be worse.
Enjoy the process. I know it's chaotic, but like, so you're chaotic. Only gonna build your van once. Enjoy the process.
No, I know.
Even the bumps.
And you're so right. And I just think like, this is like the biggest dream that is coming true. And this is the most expensive dream I've ever had. That it's actually coming true. And I'm just mind blown that like, I don't know, just that I'm doing that.
Yep.
I raise that money. I mean, I work it a ton, but like, I feel like I'm just surprising myself and proving to myself that like anything is possible. You just have to grind sometimes.
100%. Put a plan in place and then execute the plan.
Yeah. That's how I found my van. Yeah!
Spoiler alert, we didn't have to wait till she's in van life. We're in a relationship. You can edit that out later if you want.
What's our anniversary date?
Oh, anniversary actually is August 17th. When did you actually allow me to call you my girlfriend? April 9th of 2021. 9 months later.
Girls, work on yourself first. It's important.
Guys, find a girl that's worth chasing.
Oh, I love you.
I love you.
Good job, proud of you.
Thank you.
Killed it.